Izotope Vinyl is an incredible free lo-fi plugin that's great for creating that vinyl sound or adding some vintage character to your tracks. I'm Zane from AudioTechTV.com, and today I'm going to look at the Izotope Vinyl plugin, and I'm going to put it on various tracks like drums, bass, and overall mixes so you can see how this free VST plugin can add some interesting character to your tracks. And I've linked to it in the description below just in case you want to go over to Izotope's site, get some more information on it from them, or download it for yourself. Now let's listen to it on a simple 808 drum track. Now let's have a quick look at the controls. You have the mechanical noise slider, which adds mechanical sounds like click and rumble. You can use the slider to increase or decrease the volume of the mechanical sounds. The wear setting simulates a worn record. Use this slider to adjust how much of the wear filtering and distortion that it adds. The electrical noise control adds a 60 Hz hum, and the slider controls how loud that hum is. Both the mechanical sound and the electrical noise should be used sparingly. They're designed to make the quiet sections of your songs not sound too digitally quiet. Now, with the dust setting, you have two controls, one for the amount of dust to add, and the other one for the volume of the dust. Scratch is another setting that has two controls. The amount knob controls how many scratches that you add, and you can really go over the top with this, so you may not want to crank this up. And the slider controls the volume of the scratch. So if you have the slider cranked, it will likely sound like muted sections in your audio. Try to dial it in so it just sounds like a slight skip, not really a dropout. The warp depth setting works with the warp model buttons down here. Now, these buttons change the warp type, and the fader controls the amount of the warp that you add. So this can be fun to play around with, and you can really come up with some great lo-fi sounds with it. If you press the spin down button, it will give you the effect of a record player being powered down while still playing the record. The year setting adds a filter that basically reduces the frequency range. The older the date, the smaller the frequency range. The 2000 setting doesn't add a filter at all, so basically it's a bypass for the filter section. The RPM section controls how often the scratches, dust, and warp happen. A 78 will make everything happen more frequently, and the 33 setting will be the least frequent. Now the rest is pretty straightforward. The bypass turns the plugin off and on, so you can compare the original sound to the affected sound. You can also adjust if it's stereo or mono, and you can control the input signal and the output signal with these sliders. You can actually create more distortion here by increasing the input, and decreasing the output so you're not clipping your track. Now, before we listen to Izotope Vinyl on more tracks, I just want to ask, if you're enjoying this video so far, can you please hit that thumbs up button? It really does help the channel out, and I appreciate it so much. Now, let's listen to Izotope Vinyl on some more sounds. And here it is on a drum and bass section. And here it is on an entire mix. Now you can see how Izotope Vinyl can add some interesting character to your tracks. And if you want to check out even more free VST plugins, click up here. Or click down here to see what YouTube thinks you should watch next. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos from me. Thank you so much for watching. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.